Then our panel of excellent young critics met to once again hash out the inner meaning of this metaphysical masterpiece.
And I like this movie. I think it's destined to become a cult classic, but I mean, I enjoyed it. You know who stole the show, though? Of course, Keanu Reeves and Alex Winter were both excellent, but William Sadler...
Keanu Reeves and the other guy, that's how you should refer to him.
Yeah, and the other guy.
No, I wouldn't.
William Sadler from Die Hard 2, he was in, stole the show as the Grim Reaper. He was hilarious. That one scene...
John, I don't know what cult will have this film as a classic. This film is so bad that watching it gave me like stomach cramps. I don't even want to about this movie.
What? Maybe you did have stomach cramps.
It had nothing redeemable whatsoever.
But didn't you appreciate at least the parody aspect of it? Because that's what I like the most about it. These are two nice guys, and even though there's not really a whole lot to the plot, the whole point is that it's kind of pointless, and they make fun of everything. They make fun of life and death and pretentious movies dealing with that.
Did you see the first one before you had seen this
Yes, I did, unfortunately.
I think that you'd have to see the first one, because
I don't know about
there's so many unanswered questions from the excellent adventure.
I don't think you have to so much see the first one, just to buy into this idea.
Yeah.
I mean, if you don't like Bill and Ted, you're not gonna like this movie, but I thought it was hilarious.
I thought they were appealing characters, too. Yeah.
I think Keanu Reeves is completely wasted. I don't know why he did this movie. They must have paid him tons of money.
Hey, it takes talent to look as empty-headed as he does in this movie, okay?
It does?
And exceptionally stupid.
Visit the White
House. What they did.
Okay, but you gotta admit, that one scene where Bill and Ted are playing the games with the Grim Reaper, although they gave a lot of it away in the commercials.
Yes, they gave all of it away.
So I guess basically Jonathan and Vincent and I appreciate the parody aspect of it, while Tony didn't really like it. So would you guys say this was intended for a teen audience?
Yeah, definitely.
So there you have it. Back to you, Michael and Jeffrey.
As I recall, when this great motion picture first came out, we both thought that it was definitely an improvement over the original.
Which leads me to think you're counting the minutes till Bill and Ted number 3.
I can't wait. And to Wayne's World, of course. Well, now to summarize...